Today, we will analyze a poem, London, by William Blake. An English poet and painter lived from 1757 to 1827. He was a painter and a printmaker too. He moved from London to the village of Feltham in 1800, but he returned in 1804. He often wrote about rebelling against the misuse of power and class, and this is the thing that is discussed by Blake in this poem. The poem was published in Songs of Experience. Those were the days of Industrial Revolution, and when the Blake was born, the population of London was 660,000. About 100 years later, it was over 3 million, and the major influence for the rise of the population was Industrial Revolution, and that was something Blake was opposing. The poem is about dirt, filth, disease, prostitution, and child labor, and also speaks how Thames River looks at night. So let's start the main context of the poem, London. London is a very sneaky and dark poem. There is nothing about Great Thames looks at night, nothing about England's rich history, literary history, basically everything that Blake felt was wrong about the city. So guys, let's start the poem. I wander through each chartered street, near where the chartered Thames does flow. And mark in every face I meet, marks of weakness, marks of woe. In every cry of every man, in every infant's cry of fear, in every voice, in every ban, the mind-forged manacles I hear. How the chimney sweepers cry, every blackening church appalls, and the hapless soldier's sigh runs in blood down palace walls. But most through midnight streets I hear how the youthful harlots curse, blast the new-born infant's tear, and blights with plagues the marriage hearse. The poet opens London by telling us a little story. He says, I wander through each chartered street. Main har mehdood gali se guzra. Chartered means mapped out or confined. So I wander through each chartered street. Main har mehdood ya designated gali se guzra. Near where the chartered Thames does flow. Kareeb wahan se jahan mehdood Thames darya behta hai. It's mean that Blake says Thames is not a very large infinite river. It's confined by the people that logon ne Thames river ko khud hi mehdood kar liya hai, uski hadood ko. And mark in every face I meet, marks of weakness, marks of woe. Blake says, aur main wahan yani is raste se jahan se guzra, जिस किसी से भी मिला तो उसके चेहरे पर कमजोरी और अफसुर्दगी के आसार थे. पोइट सा साइंस ऑफ वीकनेस एंड अनहैप्पीनेस ऑन एवरी फेस ही मेट. हेयर यू कैन सी विजुअल इमेजरी, द इमेजरी ऑफ सफरिंग इन दिस लाइन, मार्क्स ऑफ वीकनेस, मार्क्स ऑफ वो. इन सेकंड स्टांजा, इन एवरी क्राई ऑफ एवरी मैन, इन एवरी इन्फेंट्स क्राई ऑफ फेयर्स, तमाम छोटे बच्चों की खौफ से चिल्लाने की आवाज़ों में. इन्फेंट मीन्स न्यू बॉर्न बेबी और अ बेबी लेस देन 7, यानी लंदन में पैदा होने वाले बच्चों की खौफ से रोने की आवाज़ों को पोइट सुन सकता है. इन एवरी वॉइस, इन एवरी बैन, हर आवाज़ में, हर बंदिश में, हर रिस्ट्रिक्शन में. बैन मीन्स हर पाबंदी में. द माइंड फोर्ज्ड मैनकल्स आई हेयर, जहन या दिमाग को लगाई गई जंजीरों की आवाज़ें मैं सुन सकता हूँ, मैं सुनता हूँ. माइंड फोर्ज मीन्स हिटिंग मेटल्स इन ऑर्डर टू वेल्ड हिम टुगेदर टू पुट माइंड इन अ केज ऑफ चेन्स. द चेन्स मे बी द चेन्स ऑफ सफरिंग्स गिवन बाय द लॉ एंड रिस्ट्रिक्शंस बाय गवर्नमेंट. द वर्ड मैनकल्स इज यूज्ड फॉर रिंग चेन, used to prevent a prisoner from escaping. You might say hathkadiyan, bediyan, tok, etc. Man is born free, but everywhere he is in chains, said by a philosopher. It means that poet can hear the voice of cry of people and of chains or sufferings. Those are designed to make them weak mentally or physically. Here, the repetition of words like chartered, every, and cry emphasizes on the sufferings of people. It shows how life is suffering in London. In these two stanzas, sufferings of people living in London are shown by creating different visual imageries. The third stanza is about causes of these sufferings, while fourth stanza is again about the sufferings in society. How the chimney sweepers cry. Poet hears the cries of chimney sweepers. A chimney sweeper is exactly that somebody that cleans chimneys. Back in Blake's days, this wonderful, disgusting, dirty, dangerous job was usually reserved for children. These little kids went down the chimneys to clean them because they were small enough to fit and hence ideal for the task. Chimney sweeping is a really dangerous job. Most of the kids that were lucky enough to do work were orphan, often under the protection of church, and they usually didn't bath very often and were thus dirty for days on end. Lots of the kids got lots of cancer from spending so much time working in it. Next line, every blackening church appalls. Aur ye har church ke liye bahut shameful baat hai. Appalls means shameful. As it is mentioned, this job usually fell to orphan in the care of church and other religious institutions, which explains why the poet mentions a blackening church. The chimney sweepers cry. The church is partially responsible for it. Therefore, that cry shames the church. And the hapless soldier's sigh runs in blood down palace walls. The basic idea is that the palace, which is here a symbol for government, has blood on its hands. Badnaseeb sipahiyon ki aah bhari awaazein ya aahein, khoon bankar shahi mahal se niche ko behti hain uski diwaron se. Sigh means aah bharna, and word hapless stands for unlucky or unhappy. Actually, one of the major political events of William Blake's lifetime was the French Revolution, and he was initially a supporter of this revolution, whose impact can be seen in his poetry. In the last stanza, fourth stanza, Blake again speaks of sufferings in London. But most through midnight street I hear, magar aksar aadhi raat ko un galiyon mein main sunta hoon. How the youthful harlots curse, kaise jawan fahsha ladkiyan cheekhti chillati hain. It means how young prostitutes curse the society. Harlots means prostitutes, fahsha bazari aurat. Blasts the newborn infant's tear, नए पैदा होने वाले बच्चों के आंसुओं को जला देती हैं. इट्स मीन्स उन प्रोस्टिट्यूट्स के जो बच्चे होते हैं वो रोते हैं और हर तरह से चीखने चिल्लाने की दर्दनाक आवाज़ें आती हैं उन प्रोस्टिट्यूट्स की और उन बच्चों की. हेयर्स अनदर पॉइंट इज दैट पॉइंट इज मेकिंग इज दैट बेबीज आर बॉर्न इन टू अ वर्ल्ड वेयर यंग वुमेन हैव बिकम प्रोस्टिट्यूट्स एंड ब्लाइट्स विद प्लेग्स द मैरिज हर्स. और ये सफरिंग्स शादी को स्पॉइल करके मौत में तब्दील कर देती हैं. ब्लाइट्स मीन्स स्पॉइल्स. प्लेग मीन्स कॉज समथिंग टू डिफिकल्टी और सफरिंग. एंड द वर्ड मैरिज हर्स स्टैंड्स फॉर डेथ ऑफ मैरिज. हर्स मीन्स अ व्हीकल यूज्ड टू कैरी अ बॉडी टू अ फ्यूनरल. द कर्स द फैक्ट दैट देयर इवन इज अ यूथफुल हार्लट इन एग्जिस्टेंस completely destroys the institution of marriage. This is why poet uses the phrase marriage hearse. We associate marriage with children, life and union. A hearse obviously symbolizes death. Means marriage is a hearse because Well, unmarried harlots are running around. Babies seem to have no mothers, and there are no fathers to be found. Marriage has been plagued. These sufferings add insult to injury. So, friends, the rhyme scheme of the poem is ABAB. And you can see that cyclical repetition is used, as the first and second stanza, both stanzas are talking about sufferings, and the third one is about causes of sufferings, and the fourth one is again about sufferings. So cyclical repetition is used here, and the poem is whole poem is written in iambic tetrameter, that each line carry 8 syllables, but a few lines like the line marks of weakness, marks of woe, carry 7 syllables. And these use of 7 syllables shows the weakness of line. Actually, the poet is weakening the line by excluding one syllable to show the weakness of the line, and the weakness, marks of woe. So, friends, if you have any confusion, let me know in the comment box. See you in the next video.